You got this guy playing Jenga with the shells, Knuckles. Hey, Dave, you like that beat, baby? There's some really disturbing things they say, propaganda and subliminal messages. Now listen to what he says right here. Going to kill some kids. He just said, listen closely. I'm going to kill some kids. I'm going to kill some kids today. His words, not mine. He just literally said, I'm going to kill some kids today and make them into ice cream. I'm going to find some chubby kids and we're gonna make some ice cream fun. I'm gonna kill some kids today, he said. Find some chubby kids, make some ice cream and have some fun. I'm going to kill some kids. I'm going to find some chubby kids and we're gonna make some ice cream fun. What the hell is he doing? I mean, that whole how old he says he's gonna do to kids. I'm telling you, this is crazy. Walt Disney does the same thing, which has a child audience. They have some of the most numerous examples of subliminal sex symbols embedded in their movies and their kids shows, even right in their cartoons. You can just look up. Google this, Google Disney subliminal, and you'll see the Little Mermaid erection cover, right on the castle pillars. You'll see naked people in that movie, in the 1977 movie The Rescuers, about the mouse in the background. This is supposed to be a kid show, kid movie. I mean, take your pick, it's everywhere. And the point is reality is full of occult and sex symbols everywhere. We spoke about that earlier in the introduction. So even in our culture, in our art, there's always some type of, by the mainstream media, there's always some type of sick and twisted shit hidden. It's everywhere. The symbolism in these movies and cartoons are just the tip of the iceberg, because our society is being fucked with very hard by the Masonic sorcerers, engineers, the artists, the engineers that are supposed to shape your attention and mold you into being a consumer who doesn't realize their true power, who doesn't realize that you're literally a god here on earth. Navigating your mythical narrative and writing it as you go, creating your reality as you go. But our society is being fucked with so hard. That explains all the symbolism in movies and cartoons and art, especially. Commercials are a big thing from the major corporations embedded with symbolism and subliminals. Some of the subliminals are satanic, some sexual. But mostly they're occult, mythological references that are important in the competing secret societies. So it's right in front of our face, mocking you. There's like so many examples. This is a great example of it in these Sonic reels on YouTube. Right, and the reels are really, really, really high powered in terms of hijacking your brain. Right, because they hit the brain so hard, and they give the kids, when they're scrolling, dopamine fixes. Oh, that's good. That's good. That's good. And they like that video was great. Let me get another one. That's another one. The dopamine goes up and up, so much so that once they're off there from scrolling and watching the reels, they can't even concentrate on anything, on any school, which is brainwashing a lot of it anyway. But there are some good stuff you learn in elementary school for sure. Math and science. And if you have a good teacher, critical thinking. Well, you even in sports, they can't. Nowadays, it's hard for them to pay attention to direction because they want that dopamine fix and they're not willing to sit through a lesson and then complete the lesson with their actions. So, comment from David Little.
And let you go. You ain't down with that. Shut your goddamn ass.